filming.
Oh. Hey, Miguel. How's it going? Good to see you again. First off, what do you think about this fight that you have coming up at the StubHub Center? And really, what does it mean to you to be challenging for a world title?
You know, it's an honor for me.
You're at the StubHub Center. It's a venue that you've never been to before. What does that mean to you? Because I know StubHub Center has given a lot of good fights over the years as well.
Yeah, good to meet you.
Much admiration. We remake a boxing StubHub. I'm going to do my best.
Kamba guy's kind of a big guy. Did you notice that? What do you make of that?
Yes, I'm only boxing. He has two hands to fit like me, and all that he's going to talk about the matter of Pagos is going to be the way we handle it.
Miguel, you're one of the biggest names in boxing. You're a superstar, you're popular, and people say you should retire. Why do you think they're saying that?
I don't know. I'm happy to be here. I'm healthy. I'm good here, you know. People see what would Miguel Cotto have in boxing.
You take care of it.
A very aggressive, come forward style. A lot of offense, not a whole lot of defense. As a fighter of your caliber, is that something that you're excited about, knowing that you have a guy who's you're not going to have to find, he's going to be right there?
We're going to start camp on the beginning of July. I know Freddie already had the strategy, plan on his mind to work against Kamagai. And I know we're going to find the key to beat him.
We know with your deal with Roc Nation, you had, I believe it was 3 fights total, but you only did 1 with them.
2.
2. There were 2 left, right? Or 2 total. Okay.
2 total, yeah.
So, being that this would have been the second one, do you, like he was talking about retiring, it seemed like you were close to retiring when we were talking about the Kirkland fight. Is that still the case?
I'm going to take the rest of this year in boxing, and we'll probably retire after this year.
Miguel, what do you think about Triple G Canelo? I mean, you fought Canelo, you know Triple G.
It's going to be a great fight. You know, it's going to be a great night for boxing all around the world. And I know it's going to be, it's the kind of fight that the sport needs.
What would you rate Saul Alvarez's power with Canelo? How would you rate his power when you fought him? Do you think you could hurt Golovkin?
I think that they're a really skilled guy, really strong boxers, and they have to find the key to beat each other.
Last question.
On their fight.
Miguel, you take care.
What happened with Roc Nation? Why did you decide to leave them and go over to Golden Boy? If you could elaborate on your decision to do that.
We just decided to split our relationship because we understood that we are going to be better nation on the head and go on his bed, and that was all.
Was it a money thing, or was it something that you weren't happy about?
It just was, we understood that we really can go further in our relationship, and we just decided to
Miguel,
okay,
with
thank
retirement,
you. We have to cut it. Sorry. Sorry.
Thank
next
you
time.
Thanks,
thank you.
Thanks, Miguel.
We're going to bring more. Yeah.
Good luck.
Thank you.
This way, right here.
That way.
Tom Hogan in the house. Brian, how you been? Good?
Good at you, man.
I'm betting on Miguel Cotto for this one.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Did you see her? Thanks.